A lot of the most impactful actions in sustainability are invisible. So one of the missions of my office is an educational mission. And I like to talk about those things that are sort of out of sight, out of mind, because they're often more effective in reducing our footprint than some of the more visible things. We are surrounded by art, sculpture art, that is going to be entered into a contest that will end on November 16th at our sustainability open house.
What has happened over the past month or so is that local schools and arts organizations have come forward and done projects with their classes and with their groups. Families have devised teams. The parents have made something with their children. Some of the children are over 12, some of the children are under 12, and some teams have simply borrowed somebody's child.
We in the United States carry a particular responsibility for global sustainability. We are the most resource-consuming nation on the planet.
We came together to call this a trash sculpture contest as opposed to anything else, because trash has a certain reputation of being not very worthy to be used to make art. So there's a little bit of a paradox going on here. You know, we have this whole gallery set up now to showcase the trash. And I think it's a real testimonial to the ingenuity of the artists that some of the pieces are so beautiful.
So as an institution of higher education, we believe it's our responsibility to participate in that discourse and to help discover solutions. The 2008 sustainability plan had three components to it. Resource conservation is one, greenhouse gas reduction is another, and the third is research, education, and civic engagement. This year, we're publishing our second progress report, and we have a lot more to show. What we're showing now is a 2.5% reduction in our emissions since 2008. But since 2008, we've actually added more than 350,000 square feet of built space. So we've been growing the campus, but at the same time reducing our carbon footprint.
So what happens to the pieces after the sustainability open house is this. The artists may retrieve their work after the prizes are awarded, and if they don't, it once again becomes trash.
To me, it doesn't really matter what it is that you get engaged in, because that will be a gateway to other things. Maybe it's engaging in an art contest. Maybe that's the gateway, where you suddenly realize that there's an impact from some of our daily behaviors, and you've just made art out of it. To help communicate that concept. So there's lots of things that the individual can do.